I've got like a Hugh Jackman Wolverine thing going. I don't know what to do. Zombieland, Double Tap. Now, this is a pretty short movie with not a whole lot of nuance, so don't expect me to keep you here for 5 straight minutes, alright? I'm gonna keep things short and simple, just like the movie does. Zombieland, Double Tap is set 10 years after the original Zombieland movie. At least I think so. I mean, all the characters they seem like they're 10 years older. But, I've done like 200 of these, and I still don't know what I'm doing. Basic plot is the original crew from the first movie, Columbus, Tallahassee, Little Rock, and Wichita, played by Jesse Eisenberg, Woody Harrelson, Abigail Breslin, and Emma Stone, respectively, have set up shop in the White House. They live there now. That is basically their fortress of solitude. And Little Rock, she's about my age, maybe a little older. She's starting to get cabin fever. She's horny. She's just horny. So she wants to go find a boy. And she does, and then she goes missing. And so basically the main plot of the movie is let's go find Little Rock. And along the way, there's a lot of really funny stuff that happens. I mean, it's a comedy first, and it definitely excels at that. There was one gag that I kind of wish hadn't been given away in the trailer. You know, the one where it's like they meet their doppelgangers, basically. But I mean, the best stuff from that gag is left for the movie, so it doesn't really feel like it's too wasted. And then a lot of the more funny stuff from that happens in the movie is also left out of the trailer. So most of the really funny material you're seeing for the very first time in the movie, and I really appreciate that. And one complaint that I've seen about this movie over and over again is that, oh, it came out way too late. It should have come out 7 or however many years ago. And the only reason that I could see any merit to that whatsoever is because the whole zombie thing is played out now. I mean, at the time that it came out, there were no Walking Dead shows. Call of Duty Zombies wasn't a huge thing yet. I don't even think it existed yet. Like all these things where zombies kind of get played out. You know, there weren't 45 different zombie movies coming out every single year. But funny enough, the movie does have a lot of nods to that sort of thing. It doesn't spend too much time trying to justify its own existence, but it does poke fun at a lot of the complaints that they knew people would have, like, why did it take so long? That sort of thing. So if you feel that way, the movie understands that, and it does take a little bit of time out to poke fun at itself with you. And the movie had my favorite thing of all the things that a movie can have. It had a lot of heart. There's a lot of heart in this movie, and it goes a long way. And it's, you know what? I love these characters. And Emma Stone said she'd want to do one of these every 10 years. So if they do a Zombieland 3 in 2029, I will be there. I will watch it. I will eat it all up. And in the end, Zombieland Double Tap is absolutely worth buying on Blu-ray. I will, because I like to laugh, and I thought it was very, very fun. Zombieland Double Tap. Have you seen it? What did you think about it? Whatever it is, whatever you think, comment below and educate me. And as always, if you want more videos from me, leave a like, subscribe if you're new, click the screen, and you know what? I'll see you very soon.